I'm John Neill, and I'm a wildlife biologist with the Great Salt Lake Ecosystem Program, which focuses on the management of brine shrimp harvest on Great Salt Lake, lake research, and conservation of lake resources. Today, I'll be presenting the habitat management plan for the Hat Island Wildlife Management Area. Utah State Code requires a prepared management plan for each wildlife management area and stipulates what should be included in each plan, such as proposed or anticipated uses, management limitations or conditions, inventory of existing conditions, desired future condition of the area, strategies to achieve the desired future condition, and any reallocated forage, water, or other resources. DWR presents the plan to various stakeholders, and following approval by the DWR director, the plan is used to manage Hat Island Wildlife Management Area, or WMA for short. The review process for each management plan starts with DWR staff in the Northern Region office. Since Hat Island WMA is located in the Northern Region, the plan is then presented to the DWR's Habitat Council. With any suggested changes, the plan is submitted to the Resource Development Coordinating Committee, or RDCC, in the Utah Governor's Office, where they post it for public review. As a courtesy to Box Elder County, where the WMA is located, the plan is presented to the Box Elder County Commission before finally being presented to the Northern Regional Advisory Council. If there are any major concerns about the plan voiced by the RAC, I'll present the plan to the Wildlife Board. Hat Island Wildlife Management Area is found near the middle of Great Salt Lake, next to the southeastern border of Box Elder County, within the red circle shown in the middle of the map on the right. The red circle also represents a 1 mile buffer around the island. Gilbert Bay, the main portion of the lake, is east of Hat Island, and Carrington Bay is to the west. I will also mention later Promontory Point, which is northeast of Hat Island and is the southern tip of the peninsula extending into the northern half of Great Salt Lake. Gunnison Island and associated Cub Island, which is also a state wildlife management area, is located in the northwest part of the lake in Gunnison Bay. And the blue line surrounding the lake is the Great Salt Lake Meander Line. It was created during 18 surveys from 1855 to 1966. Everything within the meander line is considered state sovereign land, effective at Utah statehood on January 4th, 1896. And the extent of the Great Salt Lake, shown in gray on the map, represents an average lake elevation. This satellite imagery shows the current extent of Great Salt Lake, which is about 1.5 feet below the all-time, or excuse me, 1.5 feet above the all-time low, or about 8 feet below average. You can see that Hat Island is connected to the surrounding land by an extensive land bridge here, shown by the pointer, to the south of the island. Here's a close-up of Hat Island, which is about 1,500 feet in diameter, and a 1 mile-long sand spit extends from the south end of the island. In the map to the right, state sovereign land is in purple, and DWR land is in brown. The circle, again, represents the 1 mile buffer surrounding the island. Guano harvesters started working the island in the mid-1890s and filed for a mineral patent, gaining private ownership in 1906. Hat Island WMA, along with Gunnison Island WMA, were created through the Pelican Management Act of 1977, and the act authorized the condemnation, purchase, and creation of both Hat and Gunnison Island WMAs. And according to the 1980 court decree that gave ownership of Hat Island to the Division of Wildlife Resources, the subsurface mineral rights with stipulations were retained by the previous owners. One stipulation said that if the subsurface mineral rights were not acted upon for 20 years, those rights would be forfeited. And these rights have not been acted upon and could be considered expired in a court of law. The division holds fee simple title to a little over 22 acres, which was officially acquired in 1980. Administrative rule permanently closes Hat, Gunnison, and Cub Islands to the public, including a 1 mile buffer in every direction. No freshwater or springs are located on the island. The primary purpose of the WMA is to preserve and protect Hat Island for wildlife use in perpetuity, particularly colonial nesting species like California gull, black-crowned night heron, which has a nest with eggs here on the left. Also a great blue heron with chicks in a nest here on the right, and American white pelican and Caspian tern. Due to the remoteness of Hat Island, habitat management is limited to an annual aerial photo survey in May to catalog nesting bird species and their extent, as in the photo on the left showing nesting California gulls and a great blue heron surrounded by the green shrubs here. There is also an annual visit to the island to maintain a weather station, which is the only functional structure on the island. Wildlife known to the island includes 15 avian species, with 6 species known to have nested on the island, like American white pelicans. Pelicans last nested on the island in 1943 with about 4,000 nests. California gulls nest on the island annually and represent the 6th largest colony in the United States. The National Audubon Society designated nearby Gilbert Bay as a globally important bird area, or IBA, meaning greater than 1% of the global population of a species resides in the area. California gulls on Hat Island alone qualify Gilbert Bay as a global IBA. 6% of its North American breeding population is at Hat Island. And incidentally, 17% of the California gulls that nest at Great Salt Lake do so on Hat Island. There are 2 known species of greatest conservation need on Hat Island. Those are American white pelican and Caspian tern, though neither currently nest on the island. Based on habitat characteristics surrounding Hat Island, there are 2 other potential breeders or migrants to the WMA that are also species of greatest conservation need. Snowy plover may nest on the mudflats surrounding Hat Island, and kit fox is known to be in the uplands nearby. There are also 4 mammals. 3 of these are rodents and coyote. The rodents are North American deer mouse, chisel-toothed kangaroo rat, which is pictured above, and a house mouse that was thought to have been a stowaway on one of the tourist boats long ago. 2 lizards are also known to the island, the northern side-blotched lizard, which is pictured below, and the great basin whiptail. There are 3 notable cultural resources on Hat Island. Pictured on the left is a handmade rock jetty located on the southeast shore of the island. At the island's central peak, there's a rock cairn with a board pictured in the middle. And connecting the jetty and the cairn is a rock-cleared path, which is pictured on the right. The WMA is home to cold desert shrub habitats and includes annuals like mustards and sunflowers, and a few shrubs like greasewood and rubber rabbit brush. Here are a few photos showing the habitat on Hat Island. The photo on the left is looking south from the island's peak, and you can see the sand spit and Carrington Island in the distance. The photo on the right looks toward the northwest with Promontory Point on the horizon. This photo on the left is looking out at Gilbert Bay. to the east of the island, and the right photo is looking west with a sliver of Carrington Bay visible in the upper right here. In this recent photo, you can see that Hat Island is connected to the surrounding land by an extensive land bridge to the south, which is the biggest habitat concern, since it allows access to the island by potential land-based predators and trespassers. Hat Island's remoteness and the fact that human access by land must cross private property help alleviate these two concerns. And with that, I thank you for listening in about the Hat Island Wildlife Management Plan today. Thank you.